video, I will tell you little-known facts about the longest continuous civilization in the world. Beer was the daily drink of the ancient Egyptians. Beer was the most popular alcoholic beverage in ancient Egypt, and it was consumed by people of all social classes. It was made from barley and flavored with various ingredients, such as dates, honey, and herbs. Beer was considered a staple in the ancient Egyptian diet, and it was consumed daily by both men and women. It was also used in religious ceremonies and was believed to have medicinal properties. The brewing of beer was an important industry in ancient Egypt, and it was often produced by women in the household or by professional brewers in large breweries. While beer was the most popular alcoholic beverage in ancient Egypt, wine was considered a luxury item and was consumed mainly by the wealthy. Wine was made from grapes and was often flavored with various ingredients such as honey and herbs. It was typically consumed at banquets, feasts, and religious ceremonies. The quality of wine varied depending on the region and the vintage, and some wines were highly valued and considered luxury items. The ancient Egyptians believed that wine had medicinal properties and used it as a remedy for various ailments. However, wine was not as widely consumed as beer in ancient Egypt, as it was more expensive and less readily available. Apart from beer and wine, the ancient Egyptians also consumed mead, which was made from honey and water. However, mead was not as widely consumed as beer and wine, and it was mostly consumed by the upper classes. The ancient Egyptians forged one of the earliest peace treaties on record. The ancient Egyptians were known for their military conquests and territorial expansion, but they also recognized the importance of diplomacy and peaceful relations with their neighbors. In fact, the Egyptians were responsible for one of the earliest known peace treaties on record, known as the Treaty of Kadesh. This treaty was signed between the Egyptian pharaoh Ramesses II and the Hittite king Hattusili, the third in the 13th century before Christ, following a long period of conflict and war between the two empires. The treaty established a boundary between the two nations and pledged both sides to peaceful relations and mutual aid in the event of outside aggression. The treaty was inscribed on a silver tablet, and copies were sent to both capitals as a symbol of the agreement. The Treaty of Kadesh is considered a landmark moment in the history of diplomacy and international relations, and demonstrates the advanced political and diplomatic skills of the ancient Egyptians. The ancient Egyptians were pioneers in surgery. The ancient Egyptians were skilled in various forms of medical treatment, including surgery. Archaeological evidence suggests that surgical procedures were performed as early as the pre-dynastic period, and advanced surgical techniques were developed during the New Kingdom period. Some of the surgical procedures performed by ancient Egyptian physicians included the treatment of fractures, the removal of tumors, the amputation of limbs, and the treatment of wounds and infections. In some cases, surgeries were performed with the patient under anesthesia, using a mixture of narcotics and alcohol. The ancient Egyptians also had a sophisticated understanding of human anatomy, as evidenced by the accuracy of their embalming practices. Mummies have been found with incisions and surgical repairs that suggest the use of advanced surgical techniques. One of the most famous examples of ancient Egyptian surgery is the Edwin Smith Papyrus, which is one of the oldest known medical texts in the world. This papyrus describes various surgical procedures and treatments, including the treatment of head injuries, fractures, and spinal cord injuries. The ancient Egyptians valued their teeth. Ancient Egyptians practiced cosmetic dentistry to improve the appearance of their teeth. There is evidence that they used various methods to whiten, straighten, and decorate their teeth. One common method used by ancient Egyptians to whiten their teeth was to apply a mixture of pumice and wine vinegar to their teeth. Sometimes, this mixture included such substances as natron, a type of salt, and myrrh. This mixture acted as a mild abrasive. The mixture was applied to the teeth using a small wooden stick, and it helped to remove surface stains and plaque. Another technique used by ancient Egyptians to straighten their teeth was to bind them with gold or silver water. This method was likely reserved for the wealthy, as it required skilled craftsmanship and expensive materials. In addition to these techniques, ancient Egyptians also used various materials to decorate their teeth, including semi-precious stones, ivory, and even animal bones. These materials were often shaped and polished to create intricate designs and patterns. The ancient Egyptians invented the marriage contract. Marriage contracts in ancient Egypt were legal agreements that defined the terms of the marriage and the rights and responsibilities of the spouses. These contracts were usually written on papyrus or ostraca, small pieces of pottery or stone, and they were considered legally binding. One of the oldest known marriage contracts is the Kahan Papyrus, which dates back to around 1825 BCE, and contains a variety of legal and medical texts related to ancient Egyptian life. Among these texts is a marriage contract that specifies the terms of the union between a woman named Neferhotep and a man named Sobekmos. The contract stipulates that Sobekmos will provide Neferhotep with a house and a monthly allowance of grain and other goods, as well as clothing and other items. The contract also includes provisions for the division of property in case of divorce or the husband's death. The longest known marriage contract from ancient Egypt is the Turin Strike Papyrus, which dates back to the 12th dynasty. The papyrus contains a record of a marriage contract between a man named Ankhmos and a woman named Sagiuti. The contract is notable for its length and level of detail, and it includes provisions related to the couple's property, financial arrangements, and obligations to each other and their families. Unlike some other ancient Egyptian marriage contracts, the Turin Strike Papyrus includes provisions that allow the wife to own and manage her own property, as well as to engage in business activities. Ancient Egyptians love board games. After a long day's work along the Nile River, Egyptians often relaxed by playing board games. Several different games were played, including men and hounds and jackals. But perhaps the most popular was a game of chance known as senet. This was one of the most popular board games in ancient Egypt, and is one of the oldest known board games in the world. The game involves moving pieces along a board of 30 squares, with the goal of reaching the end of the board before your opponent. One of the pharaohs who was known to have enjoyed playing senet was Tutankhamun. Senet was a popular game during his reign, and a board for the game was found in his tomb, along with other board games and toys. In fact, Tutankhamun's tomb is one of the most important sources of information about ancient Egyptian board games and their use in ancient Egyptian society. The first known cosmetics in history were used by the ancient Egyptians. The use of cosmetics dates back to ancient times, with evidence of their use found in archaeological sites around the world. However, the first known cosmetics in history were used by the ancient Egyptians. Cosmetics were an important part of daily life in ancient Egypt, and were used by both men and women of all social classes. The earliest evidence of cosmetics in ancient Egypt comes from the predynastic period, which lasted from around 6000 BC to 3100 BCE. Archaeological excavations have uncovered pallets and containers for cosmetics, as well as traces of cosmetics themselves, including pigments and powders. Some of the earliest cosmetics used in ancient Egypt include red ochre, which was used as a pigment for the lips and cheeks, and kohl, which was used to darken the eyelids and eyebrows. Perfumes and scented oils were another important aspect of ancient Egyptian cosmetics. They were used for both cosmetic and medicinal purposes, and were often made from exotic ingredients such as myrrh, frankincense, and lotus flowers. The ancient Egyptians also believed that scents had spiritual significance, and many perfumes were used in religious ceremonies and rituals. Education was the privilege of boys from wealthy families. Education in ancient Egypt was primarily focused on training scribes and officials for administrative and religious roles. The education system was quite formalized, with schools that were often attached to temples or government institutions. The education of young boys usually began around the age of 5 or 6, with their fathers or tutors teaching them how to read and write using hieroglyphics. As they got older, they would attend school where they would continue to study reading and writing, as well as arithmetic, geometry, and basic science. The curriculum was quite rigorous and demanding, and students were expected to memorize a large number of texts and formulas. The teachers used a system of repetition and recitation to help the students memorize the material. At the end of their education, students would take an examination to determine their level of knowledge and skill. Those who passed would go on to work in government or temple administration as scribes, while others would pursue careers in other areas such as agriculture or crafts. Education was generally restricted to boys from the elite classes of society, and there is little evidence to suggest that girls received any formal education. The pyramids were not built by slaves. While the construction of the Great Pyramid of Giza was a monumental feat that required a vast workforce and sophisticated engineering skills, there is little evidence to suggest that the workers who built it were slaves. In fact, most historians believe that the workers who built the pyramid were likely skilled laborers and craftsmen who were paid for their work and provided with food, housing, and medical care. Graffiti found near the monuments suggests they often assigned humorous names to their crews, like the Drunkards of Menkaure or the Friends of Khufu. Historical records suggest that the workers who built the pyramids were organized into teams and overseen by skilled architects and engineers. They were likely drawn from all over Egypt and may have included both men and women. Some workers were also buried in the tombs surrounding the pyramid, suggesting that they were respected and honored for their contributions. For example, the so-called Workers' Cemetery at Giza, located to the east of the Great Pyramid, contains the remains of hundreds of individuals who were involved in the construction of the pyramids. Many of these individuals were likely skilled laborers and craftsmen who were involved in the carving, transporting, and placement of the massive stone blocks used in the construction of the pyramids.